Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nardus Redlinghuis, and today I'd like to explain to you how comprehensive plans work, specifically classic comprehensive plan, discovery, health. I say if you take a comprehensive plan, if you're considering to take a comprehensive plan, you take the best comprehensive plan or you leave it. So classic comprehensive, discovery, health. As an independent medical aid advisor, being in the market since 1999, classic comprehensive plan, Discovery Health, is definitely the best comprehensive plan in the country. Best benefits with best contributions. No other medical aid comprehensive plans can compare to Discovery Health's classic comprehensive plan. Now, please be so kind, do yourself a favor, go and watch my video clip on the basics of a medical aid scheme where I explain the basics. Because once you got the basics and you looked at this video about the basics, the explanation of the classic comprehensive plan will be much more easier, much more simpler to understand. Classic comprehensive plan has got four main components. The first three of the four components is situated on the risk side of the medical aid scheme. Risks consist out of 1, hospitalization, 2, rescue services, and 3, the 27 chronic conditions as laid down by law. This plan also provides day-to-day care for providers such as doctors, dentists, x-rays, blood tests, gynees, physiotherapists, hearing aids, crutches, moon boots, etc. In terms of hospitalization on a classic comprehensive plan, you can use any private hospital of your choice countrywide for both planned and emergency procedures. Any private hospital of your choice, you will be covered at 200% of the medical aid rate once you are admitted, or 200% of the Discovery Health medical scheme rate. And in terms of hospitalization, this plan has got no overall annual limit, so there is no ceiling. Rescue services, you get air and road, ambulances, helicopters to get to your emergency facility, and you also got international cover, 5 million rand per 90 days journey overseas, and that will be for emergency hospitalization and emergency evacuation. Okay, so you got hospitalization, you got rescue services, you got cover for the 27 standard chronic conditions as laid on by law, plus you got cover for an additional 33. So this is now the first main benefit enhancement of a comprehensive plan versus the other plans is, on a comprehensive plan you got cover for an additional 33 chronic conditions, whereas on the other plans you only got cover for the standard 27. Your rand values is a bit higher on the classic comprehensive plan, and your medicine list is a little bit longer. So this plan provides more medication on the formulary list, and the rand value, if you're not using medication on the formulary list, the rand value is a little bit longer as well. This plan also provides you with cancer cover, in-hospital cancer cover, and out-of-hospital cancer cover. If you are admitted because of your cancer, in hospital, it will come off the hospital benefit. It will be paid out of the hospital benefit. No overall annual limit. If it's out of hospital cancer care, on this plan you get 400,000 rand per person per year per 12 months rolling period. And everything above 400,000 out of hospital, you'll have a 20% co-payment, as the scheme will only pay 80% of the claims. So, rich risk cover benefits, hospitalization, any hospital, 200%, no overall annual limit, ambulances, helicopters, international cover, 60 conditions covered from the chronic medication benefit, and your out-of-hospital cancer care, 400,000 rand per 12 months rolling period per person. After the 400,000, you'll have a 20% co-payment. In terms of day-to-day care, And this is where most people go wrong on the classic comprehensive plan. And if you understand this, and if you know this, and if you get this, you're going to love this plan. This plan has got 3 components out of hospital, 3 benefits. And this is like in school. The first benefit is grade 1, and then grade 2, and then grade 3. In school, you begin in grade 1. Then you finish the whole year, and only then are you promoted to grade 2. Then you finish the whole year, and only then are you promoted to grade 3. You cannot spend a little bit of time in grade 1, and then a little bit of time in grade 3, and then break time, you play in grade 2. No, grade 1, finished here. Grade 2, finished here. Grade 3. So the classic comprehensive plan has got 3 components out of hospital. Grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. Exactly like in school. But now in medical aid terms, they give these grades some names. And that's where the confusion comes in. Grade 1 is called the medical savings account. Again, the ugliest word in the medical aid business, medical aid savings account. Savings means it's mine. Savings means I'm preserving it till later. Savings means I'm busy with some type of investment. If you want to invest, Sandton, Menlo Park, Investec's got buildings there, go and invest with them. You can't invest through your medical savings account. So, on the classic comprehensive plan, everything out of hospital, doctors, dentists, x-rays, blood tests, gynies, physiotherapist, hearing aids, crutches, moon boots, over-the-counter medication, prescribed medication, private nurses and casualties must, shall, and will first be paid out of the medical savings account, out of grade 1. And that is very normal. That is perfect. That is how this plan is designed. So everything must, shall, and will first be paid out of your medical savings account. And if you are on a comprehensive plan, it means you've got comprehensive day-to-day care benefits. So, on the classic comprehensive plan, you must try to use up your medical aid savings account, ASAP. Reason being, you are paying for grade 1, 2, and 3, but most people I consult with try and stretch this medical savings account as long as possible. They want to see how far they can stretch this money, and then they don't, or very seldom, very rarely, get the benefits of grade 3. Okay, so everything out of hospital must, shall, and will first be paid out of your medical savings account. And on a comprehensive plan, you want to try and use up your medical savings account ASAP. As soon as your medical savings account is depleted, you are promoted to grade 2. They said, well done, you used up all your money, now you go to grade 2. Grade 2 is called the self-payment gap. Big word. All that it says is, you now need to pay claims yourself to a specific rand amount. You do not go and bank this money somewhere. No. What do you pay? You pay a doctor, a dentist, x-rays, blood tests, gynies, physiotherapist, hearing aids, crutches, moon boots yourself. Very important is, you must submit the invoice and the receipt to claims@discovery.co.za so they can see you paid yourself. Every time they receive the invoice and the receipt, they're going to deduct. They're going to deduct it from the self-payment gap amount until the self-payment gap amount is zero. Guess what? As soon as it's zero, you get promoted from grade 2 to grade 3. Grade 3 is called the above threshold benefit. So what? What it is called? All that it says is they pay, you pay, they pay. So the medical aid paid all your out-of-hospital expenses and claims from the medical savings account while you were in grade 1. Then, as soon as the savings was used up, you were promoted to grade 2, self-payment gap. You had to pay yourself claims to the value of a specific rand amount. As soon as that was zero, you got promoted to grade 3, which is the above threshold benefit. In this benefit, the medical scheme pays again. Now, this whole thing, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, is unlimited. Unlimited. Meaning, there is no overall annual limit. There is no cap. It's an overall annual limit. There is no overall annual limit between grade 1, 2, and 3. But, they say, But they say, we will not pay more than, and I'm using this now as an example of a family of two. So, first of all, a family of two, contribution 2019 will amount to 10,445 rand. Some people ask me, is that per year? Then I say, no, that's per month. So that's a monthly contribution for a family of two on a classic comprehensive plan 2019. The medical aid savings account component will be 31,322 rand. The self-payment gap will amount to 6268. And then you got the above threshold benefit. Now, like I just said, this whole thing is unlimited, but there is certain supplements. There's no overall annual limit, but there's certain supplements. So the medical aid say, we will not pay more than 27,300 rand per person per year for dentistry at the contracted in medical aid rate. So the day-to-day key site functions at 100% of the contracted in medical aid rate. The risk side functions at 200% of the contracted in medical aid rate or discovery of medical aid rate for specialists once you're admitted. So, in terms of dentistry, you get 27,000 rand per person per year for dentistry. Very important, this is a combined benefit between grade 1, 2 and 3. Because I don't know when you're going to need the dentistry. Is it going to be in grade 1? Is it going to be in grade 3? Is it going to be in grade 2? They don't know. So the 27,300 rand is not a separate benefit. It's a combined benefit between grade 1, 2 and 3. Dentistry. Now, glasses, optical care, 5,500 rand per person per year, every year. Some medical aids came with this thing once every 2 years. This is every year per person. Combined benefit between grade 1, 2 and 3. Prescribed medication, 57,250 rand for a family of 2. Combined benefit between grade 1, 2 and 3. Very important in terms of medication, if it's schedule 3 and above, that is called prescribed medication. Schedule 0, 1 and 2 is over-the-counter medication. If you buy generic medication, it will accumulate and will be covered in full. If you buy non-generic medication, there will be a 25% co-payment or it will only accumulate at 75% of the medication price towards the self-payment gap and the above threshold benefit. It will have an implication if you don't buy generics. No one is forcing you to buy only generics. You can buy non-generics if you prefer to, but if you buy non-generics, there will be a 25% implication. So, 27,300 rand per person year for dentistry, 5,500 rand per person per year for glasses, 57,000 rand for prescribed medication, a family of 2, 58,000 for external medical items, things such as moon boots, wheelchairs, crutches per family per year, and then we got hearing aids, 24,700 rand, and we got therapeutic services, speech therapist, private nurses, etc., and therefore you get 25,250 rand per family of 2 per year. So, this again is not separate benefits. This is a combined benefit between grade 1, 2 and 3. So, everything, let's say you go for dentistry costing 20,000 rand on the 10th of Jan, the 20,000 rand will be deducted from grade 1. It will be deducted from the 51,322 rand. So, that leaves you with a balance of 11,000 rand. And you've used now 20,000 rand of your 27,000 rand. So now, if both you and your wife go for glasses to the value of 5,500 rand, then your medical savings account will be zero and your optical benefit will be depleted. Now you are in grade 2. So now you need to pay claims yourself to the value of 6268. You're not going to go and bank it. So let's say you go for a further 7,000 rand dentistry. Then you'll pay, then Discovery will pay 6,200 rand of this, that dentist account, and the remaining 732 rand will be paid from the above threshold benefit. So, if you go for dentistry, 20,000 rand dentistry, the 10th of Jan, and soon after that, both you and your wife go for glasses to the value of 5,500 rand each, your medical savings account is depleted. If you do another 7,000 rand worth of glasses, 6,200 rand of that you'll pay yourself, which will be the self-payment gap portion. The 732 rand remainder of the 7,000 rand account will be paid from the above threshold benefit. And now you are in the above threshold benefit. So now you still got 58,000 rand for external medical appliances, wheelchairs, crutches, moon boots. You got your full therapeutic benefit, 25,000 rand, psychiatrist, physiotherapist, speech therapist, etc. You still got your full medication, prescribed medication benefit of 57,250 rand, and your doctors, x-rays, blood tests, and specialists are unlimited at the contracted in medical aid rate. So the point I want to make is, if you're on a classic comprehensive plan, you must try. I don't want you to get sick or to be more sick than what you are, but if you got dentistry and if you got glasses and things coming up, try to do it as soon, as early as possible in the year, so you use up your medical savings account as soon as possible, you in your self-payment gap as soon as possible, and then you get to the above threshold benefit as soon as possible, and then you get the maximum value out of your plan. If you try and save while you're in your medical savings account, if you try to stretch the time that you spend in your medical savings account, then you waste on your monthly contribution. So if you try to save here, you will be wasting and losing there. Okay, so that's in short, classic comprehensive plan. For more information about this plan, please be so kind to visit my website.